Got right hand.
Right hand on top, Gavin. Real top.
Right hand up his ass.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? Monty Weaver here, and today we are live streaming a local boxing event. In today's video, I'm going to share with you the equipment that I'm using, how I set it up. And if you're interested in learning anything more about live streaming in general, check out all the links below this video. Let's get into it. In this video, I'm going to take you behind the scenes of a live streaming event. Over the weekend, I live streamed an amateur boxing event, a local event here, and the owner reached out to me the week of the event because they were looking for a way to live stream this. They had fighters and boxers coming from all out of town, and so obviously in the year that we're in, we needed to live stream this event so that their families, their friends could actually watch the live stream because they wouldn't be able to attend in person. And so within a couple of days, I was able to scout out the venue, understood what the requirements were, and able to put together a live stream broadcast with the help of my friend, Mr. Daniel Davis. So shout out to Daniel for coming out and helping. And he's also a boxing fan, so that made things a lot easier as well. But I'm gonna walk you through the setup and how we were even able to generate revenue for this business, because they were just looking to live stream. And we could have just live streamed to Facebook or YouTube, but we took it another step up and was able to generate revenue for the business as well. So let's jump into some of the video footage, and I'm gonna walk you through the things that we did, how that setup looked like, and give you some footage of the actual event as well. So when we arrived at the boxing gym, we already knew where we were gonna set up. Because I had previously scouted out the place, I knew where the power outlets were gonna be and a good area to mount our cameras for the good visibility that we wanted for the entire boxing match. Now, we brought our own table and we were provided with two chairs to set up. And when it comes to equipment, I'll list those all below in this video. Starting with our computer, we use the Acer Predator Helios 300 laptop, which is my gaming laptop, and I typically now use it for live streaming events. I had 32 gigs of RAM in this computer, which I had upgraded from 16, just to give myself more headroom on the processing power for when I go and live stream different events. And I also brought a secondary monitor that allowed us more visual real estate to monitor our live stream and to also monitor the output of the video. So I'll talk more about that here in a second. And then we brought multiple PTZ optics cameras. Now, originally in my mind, I wanted to do a three camera setup. And so I packed away three PTZ optics cameras in my Pelican case, but we decided to just focus on a two camera setup because it really did give us the angles that we wanted. And the wonderful thing about the PTZ optics cameras is that you really can create multiple camera shots, multiple camera angles. And so two just worked really, really well for us. The first PTZ optics camera we had set up right beside us is a 20X USB camera. So because it is a USB camera, it allowed us to run a USB cable directly from the camera into the computer without any converters. The other camera that I used was a PTZ Optics 12X SDI. So I did need to bring a SDI to HDMI converter. So we ran SDI from the camera into the SDI HDMI converter. And then from the converter, we went HDMI to an Elgato capture card USB and plugged that into the computer. So that allowed us to have a two camera angle shot, and it worked out really well for the live stream event. Now, in order to control the cameras, my buddy Daniel, he joined me and helped me put on this live stream event. And we used the Huddlecam controller. And this was connected directly to one of the cameras, and then we daisy chained it to the camera that we had mounted on the ceiling. So our 20X USB that was sitting directly beside us, we connected our Huddlecam directly to that camera, and then we ran a 50-foot cable over to our 12X camera that was up on the wall, and that way we could control camera one and camera two.
Now, the great thing about the joysticks is that you can also set up presets, which we used as well, that allowed us to get tight shots of the red corner and the blue corner. And as the boxers were moving around the ring, we were able to control it manually and go to our presets if we needed to get to that action quicker. Now, when it comes to the software of how we live stream this event, I used Wirecast 14. This allowed us to create multiple shots. It allowed us to create overlays, monitor the audio, and even record a backup copy just in case anything happened to the live stream. It's always nice to have that backup. Because this was a paid event, we wanted to make sure that we did have redundancy built in. So the platform that I chose to go with for the actual live stream broadcast was called ViewStub. Now I'm going to link below this video where you can create a free ViewStub account. And if you do any type of virtual events, this is definitely a platform you want to check out. It allows you to set up virtual only and also hybrid events as well, which means virtual and in person. It is very user friendly. You can literally go live from a smartphone. You don't even have to use production type software like OBS or Wirecast. You can just use your smartphone if you want to. So between the ViewStub platform, the Wirecast live streaming software, and all the equipment that we use, we were able to successfully put on a 4-hour live stream event. Now, if you have any questions when it comes to the setup of this live stream, definitely feel free to post it in the comment section of this video.
All right, I hope you guys got a ton of value from that video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, and I'll see you in the next video.